Welcome back to the channel, guys. I hope you guys are having a great day. Today, we are giving the Genesis its new drift buddy. This actually happened like 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
We started working on this thing. I wouldn't say we had a bad day, but we just didn't have like a great day. You know what I mean? I'm kind of glad we're back at it with like a fresh start. 2 weeks ago, we started a video where we started working on this thing.
Look at you, dude. You're halfway there. You got two different color wheels.
I just want to see what the...
Yeah, you're ready to go.
The wheel poke is going to look like with those ones on.
So today I'm going to be at Robbie's mobile welding service. Oh God.
Come on.
I'm making a mess. Which is actually pretty cool. I'm like, when I had all these tools and stuff in the shop, like as I was building it all up, it was one thing, but to like just have them in general, like I moved here, I'm doing a whole other thing and I still have like all the tools we need, it's super cool. And you guys will see too, these are like more, I guess, bronze wheels. And these are literally the same wheels, but in gold. Am I wrong?
Yeah, same wheels, different offset.
Because when Chris sold this car, the guy was like super in love with the way the car looked and he wanted to get the same wheels, but Chris wanted to keep them. So he sold the guy the car and the guy literally went and tried to buy the exact same wheels, just got them in a different color and a little bit of a worse offset. Chris's fit just a little bit better.
Look at this exhaust on this thing, man.
This guy like just literally gave it like a downpipe. Not a downpipe, but like a...
Oh, what? Why is it like all tractored out? That actually helps us a lot. Did you know it used to have like a nice exhaust on this thing?
No, remember it had the blast pipe.
Anyways, I told you guys in the last couple videos that Chris and Tim actually split this thing so that they can start drifting with me with the Genesis. The only problem with that is that this thing, like the Genesis, has an open diff. So today we're gonna take care of the fact that it has an open diff.
I know how to do her.
Don't judge how much stuff is under here, dude. The driveway is kind of like
jank.
Yeah, the driveway is kind of jank. Like it's not super flat. And Chris just doesn't trust it. He doesn't want this car coming down on our head. So we got a little bit of everything holding this thing up.
Basically, we got two sensors and then air axles. This will be nasty, probably. That bushing's gone.
The underside of this car is kind of busted, but like it's an old beater ass car. Like the point is to learn to drift on it. It's not. It's seen its good days. It's now into its bad days as he knocks a pile of rust off it. But look at the exhaust hanger they did up there.
That is just quality fresh. If I've ever seen it.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah, baby.
Oh, man, this guy.
The hidden day when you buy something.
Like, it wasn't like this when I sold it. That's for damn sure.
Yeah, that actually looks pretty fresh, too.
Yeah, it does.
Nice. It's good stuff. The remains of that.
I see a lot of rust.
It's been an embarrassingly long time trying to get this last diff bushing out. It's in a weird spot where we can't really see up into it and see what's wrong with it. All I know is it's completely rotten in there and we can't get it out. We went out and we got new sockets. We've been trying all the old sockets. It is stuck there and we are out of options. So looks like the G's gonna get some new diff bushings. Cause I think it's time to kill him, buddy.
You have fire extinguisher at your house, right?
Yeah.
Oh, there it is.
There it is.
Oh, baby.
This is the most ghetto pain in the ass thing I've had to do in so long, dude. It was so awkward to get it out that we literally, like, we didn't want to crush ourselves, so we just put this table Chris had laying around underneath so that when it fell onto the table instead of us. Because dips are surprisingly heavy, eh? Like, they're heavier than you'd think.
Yo, let's see if the nut's on them.
Oh, dude, that was
we were never getting that, man. We were never gonna get that.
I don't see anything.
There is a nut, but like, no, there's no way,
there's
man.
There's no way we were getting to it, though.
So, we just decided we're gonna order new bushings, and we just torched the living hell out of it.
See, and like, I swear, there were so many G guys that said if you had the 6-speed sedan, it automatically came with an LSD. I didn't believe them, but...
People just say that, though, because like, yeah, they think it's cool, you know?
Exactly.
I haven't had the no luxury, like, doing in a driveway in the baking sunlight.
I haven't back to Ontario, homie.
It makes me appreciate everybody that watches this and doesn't have all the luxuries that I like grew to have. And they do this shit all the time.
That's what me and you started out doing.
Exactly. Buddy. It's super funny to be like doing stupid shit like this again. We're at the point now where we have everything apart. So we got diff is out and all cleaned up.
This was the rear subframe bushing for the differential.
Which you can replace without replacing your rear subframe.
Yeah. Did you already tell them?
No, I didn't tell them.
So basically I called like 3 dealerships. Every one of them told me you cannot replace the bushing in the rear subframe, which is BS. So I went on Rock Auto, went to order the rear bushing. 2 weeks later, they emailed me and they're like, yeah, sorry, we don't have it.
Which happens all the time with Rock Auto. Rock Auto is really good, it's really cheap. You can get good stuff on there for a relatively good price, but they suck sometimes because they do this shit all the time.
Yeah.
Where you buy something and then at like the day you're expecting it to show up, they call you and they're like, oh yeah, by the way, we have never had this part in stock, so you've just been doing nothing your whole time.
Exactly what happened. On point. So then I just went ahead, got the nice Amazon special. Well, they're actually quality bushings, but
they are. White line's really nice.
So instead of doing the one bushing, we're doing all three now.
Oh, baby.
That's the package deal. So this is the one for the rear subframe.
What?
Yeah, she's fresh, eh? And then these are the other two for the sides of the diff.
So Chris is gonna work on getting the rest of that bushing out of the subframe because we can't really do a whole lot with it in the subframe. And while he does that, I'm gonna get this guy. Oh, baby. And we're gonna start making some progress here. Smells like ramen noodles. Is that me or are they like in there cooking ramen noodles? Or do you think that's just this thing?
Just like, no, that's all you, buddy.
Like all of a sudden it just stinks like noodles. I can't figure out why. All right, got this thing all welded up. Plate was like kind of painted before. So there was a little bit of fire happening like the entire time, but that's okay. It's all good, it's welded up. And then while I was doing this, Chris beat this thing out, which actually was the worst thing of life because I was done welding in like 20 minutes and then I went outside and it like it's an hour and a half later and we just got this out. We weren't filming because it was just like you can't see anything, but we had to like cut it and then
smash it
and then smash it and smash it and smash it, smash it, and like it was the worst. G is down, everything is as tight as it's gonna get. I hope, I think most of the tightening, did you hear my phone just eat it?
Yeah.
Oh, that's my water bottle, thank God. Most of the tightening's on you, so. If it's not tight.
We're gonna find out.
We're gonna find out. You can, yeah, you guys can probably hear this. I mean, like the car rolls, which is a good first start. So far, so good, buddy.
As long as it doesn't like explode, you're good. Oh, exactly.
This is trippy. Have you drove this car yet at all?
I took it once for like the test drive to see if it was worth buying back or not, but that's about it.
It's kind of weird. When I first met Chris, he had this thing. Yeah. And it was like the same. Even this didn't work.
Oh, yeah.
Cool. I like. I'm happy it's back as you manually put the window up.
It's definitely tired.
Oh yeah.
But she good.
Like for 400, what does that say?
I thought I had 422. I've been telling everyone I had 422. It's got 421. I can't even focus on it. 421,000K?
Dude, that's not bad. Trippy! Hi, buddy. Oh yeah. Yo, that's actually a pretty big little single.
I know, eh? Isn't it surprisingly?
Yeah, like his car barely takes up any space. Damn, dude. The wrap is like literally better than I expected it to be. Like that's insane. Like even in the dark, you can see this on the camera.
I feel like you've already seen this, but I guess not.
That's crazy. This is like that shitty Civic you guys have, just not so shitty. Dude, we need to go for a rip in this thing.
And then I got the roll bar in there.
Is this just become a garage queen now? Or
yeah,
what?
It is, yeah.
And the wheels look good?
You helped me with the suspension and everything.
Nice. So they look good, dude.
That is what started all of this.
Yeah, so us funding a little bit of wheels in. Nice.
I wouldn't have got crazy with this, so
nice.
It definitely helped a lot.
For everybody that like wasn't here or doesn't know or whatever, Tim's like, I hate bringing it up, but like, I don't know, how long was it? Like a year and a half ago?
A year, April 5th.
I don't even know what today is. So like just over a year and a half, Tim's old house burned down. He had his Civic, and you guys probably have heard this story a couple times, but we sold a bunch of stuff, made him some money to help at least just modify the car that he had, take his mind off whatever was going on, and this is what it's become now. Which is more than we just saw too.
Yeah, take it out in the sun and so you can see the sparkle.
And do some pulls.
Yes. Okay, so basically, like we told you guys, this is Tim and I's G35
that we bought together for drifting. Originally, I owned it, and then I sold it to a buddy of mine, and then we bought it back off him. So finally, Tim's been busy with work and kids and all that stuff in life. We got him out here tonight. The same day we put it all back together, and we're gonna let him smash some gears, hopefully.
Chris was saying how like he's beat on this car the whole time he used to own it. So he's like, we'll let Tim do the first couple drifts because just in case it pops, same thing when we get to Shannonville. He's like, the first couple rips of Shannonville like is gonna be Tim, because if anything goes, at least Chris already had his fun days with this thing, and Tim's are, you know,
yeah.
We need to make some Tim memories.
Tim's gonna have some fun days.
Yeah, exactly.
Got ourselves a spot to drift. We'll see how this guy performs.
Take one.
Yo, take one was solid. Damn.
That was it. That was tight. I think the drone, it's like super dark, but I think it's getting good shots.
Are you gonna keep going, or what do you wanna do? You wanna get out of here?
Yeah, tell me.
Leave?
Yeah, we'll get out of here and change the spot.
Close. See, that was good.